It's a Saturday night in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan, Alan May with you, and with Braden Holtby in the crease at Scotiabank Saddledome. The Washington Capitals preparing to do battle with the Calgary Flames. Kari Ramos squad 5-3-1 in this month of October. Very near the top of the Pacific Division standings, and that is a rugged bracket in the NHL. Barry Trotz, well familiar with this Calgary squad from so many years in the Western Conference with Nashville, gunning for win number 561 on his splendid career.
And what we do know is Barry Trotz's team is going to have to put their hard hats on. Bob Hartley's team works extremely hard, maybe not the most talented. They've got to be ready.
Washington in the white sweaters, Calgary here at home in red. The on-ice officials, the referees are Paul Dvorsky and Kelly Sutherland. Matt McPherson and Derek Nansen have the lines, and we have a whistle 7 seconds into the game.
And a little bit of confusion between Alzner and Ovechkin. OV saying, hey, I was going to get my stick down. He lifted it. The puck went right by him as they try to stretch pass to chip it into the zone, past Romo into his zone. Therefore, the icing call.
Cross-conference rivals. They meet twice in the next 10 days as the Flames will be in Washington, D.C. in the first week of November. Ovechkin works down the flank, guarded there by T.J. Brody with a new contract in tow.
New five-year deal over $20 million. Look for Brody along with Giordano, their captain. They're trying to shut down the Capitals' number one trio here tonight.
The Giordano snapshot turned aside by Braden Holtby. Monahan collared by Nick Backstrom. Hudler intercepts before it arrives at Ovechkin's blade. Long shot Brody off the pads of Holtby. Nicholas Backstrom in charge for Washington. In the game's opening minute, both head coaches want the line change. Swift skating Chris Russell, 27-year-old Albertan, stalked by Andrei Burakovsky at the top of the Caps forecheck. The long lead through center. Glenn Cross, always dangerous. His pass doesn't find pay dirt. Burakovsky met by Curtis Glenn Cross.
Man, Glenn Cross is much like the Capitals' Jason Chimera. They play the same style. Both excellent skaters, and on this ice sheet, they both can fly.
Marcus Johansson wheels in, tracked by Paul Byron. We're in the second minute now of this scoreless opening frame. Stage it for Glenn Cross. Calgary into this episode off of a encouraging 5-0 walloping of the Carolina Hurricanes a few nights back.
Yeah, Carolina in a whole heck of a problem area with so many injuries, Joe. They just don't match up to a lot of the teams, and they really got beat, especially in tight, by this Flames team through cycling and throwing pucks to the net.
Washington's been off since Wednesday. Goudreau working in, Schmidt right there to tend to him. Goudreau finds Schmid, long wrister, that hit traffic in front. Washington falling to Edmonton Wednesday at Rexall Place. Its first regulation loss of the young season, a mark of 3-1-2. Mike Green on home turf. Calgary native. He and Jay Beagle playing in front of a boatload of friends and family tonight. The pass for Lance Boma trickles right to Holtby's doorstep. Liam O'Brien out there with Michael Latta and Joel Ward as head coach Barry Trotz has shuffled his line combinations.
And it's all about performance. You perform well, you move up. You don't perform well, you move down. And it's sort of been his mantra since taking over the coaching job here in Washington.
Sharp looking break out there. Ramo got the glove up on O'Brien. Bolig has the rebound, former Blackhawk property. Didn't get it out. O'Brien, south of the goal line, turns, finds Latta. Niskanen's drive, armed away by Ramo. Joe Colborne, who's had a fine start to this season, especially in the assist category.
Yeah, he's right up there. 8 assists with no goals. Quite the stats line.
No score in this one. The altitude has him a little queasy. Here's Craig's voice on value, presented by Morgan Franklin Consulting.
Well, they've got to minimize their miscues here tonight. You know, they had three different ones last game against Edmonton that cost them. Not picking up Schultz, the Ovechkin whiff, then a late penalty. They can't afford those type of mistakes, especially away from the Verizon Center. They're going to have to be buttoned down and play a real strong game, especially 5-on-5 here against Calgary.
Before the day and night is done this Saturday, 11 games on the NHL slate. This is the nightcap of the Hockey Night in Canada double dip. Washington and Calgary, meeting at Scotiabank Saddledome for the 88th time all time in the series. And Washington has had very little success in the city of Calgary, regardless of where the games have been played. Colborne occupied there. Hoodler from the sharp angle put it off the outside of the cage. Monahan, the second-year pro, gave it up, and Ovechkin flies through center. Alex Ovechkin working wide against Brody on the toe drag. Backstrom following up the play. He was lassoed by Colborne. Brody with some get up and go.
You're allowed to do that here in Calgary, right?
Roping and riding.
Yeah, you're allowed to. This is Western Canada. Put on your hat and rope.
That's a Western Canadian referee guy.
Russell steps in off the pump fake. Snapshot on the way, goes right on through the paint. Dennis Weidman, former Cap, to the midpoint, Glenn Cross. Russell keeps it alive. Ovechkin shading Weidman. Loose in front, swept out of there by Nate Schmidt.
Better be aware of Weidman. He's got four goals. You know, he was a healthy scratch early on in the season by Hartley, and that sort of set him straight about how he has to play, and he's been terrific the last four or five games.
You know, you look at the Calgary roster, and all the defensemen can move the puck, and that's something different about this team. They've got excellent coaching. Players are moving the puck, and they're not just dumping and chasing. They're doing a great job of puck possession.
Johansson glides in, tried to sauce that pass, and Weidman with a good defensive play. Weidman has goals in his last three outings. Alsner a long way from the cage, sent that one wide intentionally. Russell paddles for Weidman. Dennis looks ahead. One-on-one, working in, waiting for the trailer. That's the fleet-footed Mason Raymond, former Vancouver Canuck. Sends it out wide for Schmid, and Burakovsky will have Calgary chasing in its own end.
And Mason Raymond brings a lot of speed to the lineup. Already has five goals coming back to his home turf also. They're hoping for a big boost in production from Mason Raymond.
This is Raymond with a puck. Slithers away from pressure. Swedish-born Michael Backlund's there to help. A long drive that sails high on Holtby. Five-on-five play continues. Neither team has had a man advantage to this point. We are scoreless in Calgary. Schmid. Down the wing for Backlund, dodging the brunt of that hit from Jason Chimera. Schmidt will wait. Control breakout time now for Washington in the midst of a line change. On through for O'Brien. 20-year-old swats it only as far as the Flame defender. Carlson will drive it in. Got a face full of Lance Boma playing with a full cage tonight.
Got a broken cheek, has to wear that to protect that cheekbone.
Ward on the entry, Latta helps out. Joel Ward, marked by Volek and Weidman. Latta surveys, Carlson switch it up, Green. Rister deflected and a pad save for Rama. Ward looping it for O'Brien, a sneaky feed there, knocked away by Russell. And cleared to safety.
And good job by that so-called fourth line for Barry Trotz, getting the puck in and rotating it down low. When you have O'Brien out there, he's going to throw around his body to disrupt the plays. He's got to continue to do that.
Ward trickles it into the corner. Good tempo here in the opening 7 minutes of this contest. Brody on a long lead for Colborne. Hoodler, the former Detroit property. Monahan throttled by Brooks Orpik. Ovechkin to the rescue with Backstrom zooming through center. Out wide to Eric Fair. Snapshot on the way, gloved by Rama. Colborne scoops up the rebound. Joe Colborne with eight assists, topping the Flames in that regard. Ooh, Ovechkin put a bump onto the Monahan, who just turned 20 this month. He'll reverse the flow for Giordano. Messers Hartley and Trotz with line changes on the play. On the go.
Seems like more control than anything to start this first period. It's like a cat and mouse game here. Everybody very under control, not really pushing the pace.
Icing against Calgary. On Comcast Sportsnet, we have Alan May inside the glass.
You know, if the Capitals want to beat the Flames tonight, they've got to make sure that they do a good job below the goal line. You know, the Calgary defense, they move the puck very well, but they're not the best in their own zone. You've got to get on them quick, create turnovers, and not pass up your opportunities on those quick shots. They've got to make sure that they're shooting everything at every opportunity. And one thing we didn't see in Edmonton the other night, we didn't see enough traffic, especially in the third period when they needed it most. They've got to get bodies there if they want to get on the board tonight.
Marcus Johansson digging in on the draw, Alan. Flames head coach Bob Hartley was saying how much he likes the defense pairings he's working with right now. Byron maneuvers in, trying to lose Schmidt along the boards.
You know that, Joe. You like everything when you're winning.
And they are doing that. Weidman into the corner. Glenn Cross and then Stajan. Glenn Cross, snap pass came right on through. Byron with a swing and a miss. Weidman blushed the slapper. Stajan waiting for Burakovsky, who takes the puck away. Andre Burakovsky strong on his stick. And with help from Green, the Caps should be through neutral.
Pretty impressive to play defense like that with such a young age. But he's so strong, as you mentioned it, Joe, talking about that play. And strength on his stick, having two hands on the stick, putting pressure on the ice and the puck. Real nice defensive play by the Caps youngster.
Raymond on the interchange with Goudreau. Goudreau lurking, swivels one off the skate boots of Niskanen. Beagle on the counterattack with Chimera on the dump down. Jay Beagle, for the first time in his pro career, playing in Calgary. There were 40 Beagles at the morning skate. 40 Beagles.
40 Beagles.
It wasn't messy. 40 Beagles at the morning skate.
Oh, I thought you thought the dog show was in town.
No, 40 from the Beagle clan.
Oh, okay.
150
tonight. You know I got you.
Yeah, I'm with you.
150.
Gotta
ask him how many he's buying tickets for.
He took care of the immediate family.
There's a lot of extensions, huh?
Oh, my goodness. Were there ever?
It's funny how many family members you get when you make the NHL. All of a sudden, you got people you never knew.
Dad Al, Mom Sue, beaming with pride tonight. Brooks Orpik chasing it down for Washington as we near the midway mark of this opening period. John Carlson on the go. For Liam O'Brien, skating well in this opening period. Takes a run at Weidman, supported there by Ward. Four in the quarrel. Number four comes out of there with the puck. Chris Russell for Calgary. Didn't do much with it. Latta closing in, fires. That one's deflected, and it's into that end zone safety netting for the whistle. We've played 9 minutes and 53 seconds of the opening frame. Washington nothing, Calgary nothing on CSN. Almost 20,000 can cram into Scotiabank Saddle Dome. We're here on a Saturday night, no score. Washington and Calgary on Star Trek, presented by Toyota, 2D with an offensive dimension.
For the Caps, Mike Green, 321 career points, 106 of them goals, already sitting nicely with 3 plus 3 equals 6 in points for the Caps. For the Calgary Flames, former Cap Dennis Weidman closing in. His next point will be his 300th. He's 19 away from 100 goals. He provides a lot of the O on the back line. He has 4 markers already.
Dennis, an all-star in the NHL with Washington back in 2012. Nicholas Backstrom plays back to point position for John Carlson, bumped immediately by Hudler.
Yeah, and OV took a shot to the head there down in the corner, was not detected by the referees.
And he just drilled Colborne, his opposite number 8.
Man, that's what Hartley said. You got to just let him sleep. He'd rather not see him play physical against his hockey club.
Colborne zooms down the wing. His pass deflected by Carlson. Taken off the dasher by Hudler. Wing to wing to Brody. Sends it wide of the cage, guarded by Braden Holtby. Holtby and Ramo in the net-binding matchup. Caps have another game right away tomorrow in British Columbia against Vancouver as Ovechkin was dumped. Backstrom fires, that's blocked. Delayed penalty call coming up against Calgary. Washington will have the first power play on the night.
And OV smarting his left leg. Stick right across his ankle upends him. An easy call for the referee. It didn't look like from up here he threw out his leg, but he definitely threw out his stick as Ovechkin got to the inside. Here's OV, a little chip, gets it, and there it is. It is a little bit of a leg and a stick earlier on in the shift. Here's that one I was talking about. Got clipped right up high as he took down their defenseman, TJ Brody. No call on the play, but now he gets the call going his way. The Caps on the power play.
One of the things we missed at the start of the broadcast, the very first shift that Ovechkin had, he took out that same ref, Kelly Sutherland, with a pretty heavy hit in the corner. And I think he had to wait till the third infraction of Ovi before he called something.
Special teams numbers at the bottom of the screen. Burakovsky, step late getting there. Ladislav Schmid on the send back. Boma works in one-on-one. Niskanen keeping an eye on him. Flames will play keep away here. Lost it. Ward's in. Fires. He scores! Joel Ward.
Best thing that can happen on a penalty kill is a shorty. It deflates everybody. You can see the fans, just a big sigh as Ward just snaps it past the catching glove on the power play. Sorry, it was a power play goal by Joel Ward, who snaps it. Bad clear by the Flames, who are trying to play four corners. They try to move the puck around, a bouncing puck, and there's Wardo getting an opportunity on the power play. There's the miscue. It'll be unassisted on the power play, and Wardo rips it home past Robbo.
And the key to that goal, Locker, when you look at it, is something we saw the Calgary Flames working on all morning. Stick the puck, stick on the ice, making sure you're moving forward, and you create those opportunities for yourself. And Joel Ward stick on the ice the entire time, and what a beautiful shot. He knew that Robbo was going to go down and collapse in that position. Very cagey shot.
First time in his career in 16 games against the Flames, and Joel Ward has struck for a tally. Ward at 11-17, unassisted on the power play. Green gallops into the offensive zone, towards the front, behind his intended target. Chimera offers for Schmidt a long drive that goes wide. Mike Green will scale in. That's a delayed offside, and it's now whistled as Kuznetsov touches the puck. 8 minutes, 18 seconds to go in the opening period tonight. North of the border in Calgary. Washington off to a good start. The power play continues to percolate. Joel Ward on the board.
A couple of lines aren't going as well as I thought they would, and therefore they look a little stale. And sometimes just shaking up a couple guys or just a line and moving one person in and out can just sort of get everybody's attention. I just don't want to get into a little bit of a rut where I think offensively we've gotten to a little rut here where we're not doing what we're necessarily should be doing.
In our legal seafoods bite of the night, Barry Trotz explaining his thought process behind juggling the lines that we have seen employed in this first 20 minutes in Calgary. And you're getting on board late with us this Saturday night. Joel Ward a few moments ago, his third of the season on the power play, this one unassisted at 11-17, giving the guests the advantage.
He confused me. I thought they were penalty killing. He messed me all up on that nice snapshot. And for the Caps, Barry Trotz, he's been able to roll all four lines in this first period. Everyone's getting an even Steven shift. Ward the only marksman.
Blaine Forsythe in conversation with Barry Trotz. Just a shade over 8 minutes to go in this opening period. Ward now with goals against Boston, New Jersey, and Calgary. As Niskanen propels one. Good pad save there. Romo denying Ward a second tally.
Man, they were talking and working on that practice here in Calgary about getting more guys to the front of the net looking for tips and deflections. Watch Wardo just poke his stick out right there ahead of the defender, high in the slot. Excellent stop by the Calgary netminder.
10th year pro Joel Ward answering, quote, his demotion to the fourth line.
Yeah.
With a sharp first period tonight. Out there with Liam O'Brien and Michael Latta. Back to point position. It'll get away from Niskanen and he'll retreat. Teaming up with Carl Alsner on the blue line for the Capitals. Second game of a three-game road swing. Vancouver awaits tomorrow. 9:30 Eastern time, our start on Comcast Sportsnet. From Rogers Arena. Fair trying to take away the wall from Dennis Weidman. Raymond is there. He'll backtrack. Russell, very fleet of foot. Drives it ahead. Calgary not liking the way Washington's been stacking things up for them in the neutral zone. Fair on the advance. Came on through Backstrom. It turns out to be icing against the Washington Capitals. Folks on Twitter tonight, hashtag Capitals Talk. Which Caps player would you most want to hang out with for a day in D.C.? Hashtag Capitals Talk. Which Caps player would you want to hang out with in our nation's capital? Plenty of good-natured guys who could be a chum for a day.
Oh, yeah.
Ovechkin right on target for Fair. Strolling into the offensive zone. Hudler put the hook on Backstrom. 5-on-5 play continues. The Ward power play goal has given Washington the advantage. It comes on through. On the delay, fire. Holtby makes the glove save. It trickled off of him. as the youngster Monahan, who cashed in twice against Carolina, was thirsty for another.
After a slow start, not getting a goal to start the season, finally broke free. And he's a guy last year who had a tremendous rookie year, Joe B. He had 22 goals for this team.
Orpik channels it on through Troy Brower. Brower, Burakovsky, Johansson out there now for the Caps. Get the whistle here. Face off to come back in the defensive zone for the Flames.
And Brooks Orpik, along with Burakovsky, holding down the fort defensively. One thing that we've seen from this team, and Alan May, you can weigh in, so much better defensively. Just the guys reading one another, knowing what to do, the center working perfectly with the defense.
Well, the coaches are consistent in their message every time, and there's more back pressure on the puck. You've got the other two trailing forwards getting back as hard as they can, and there's five men overloading on one side of the ice. It makes it easier for the defensemen to get their reads in on those odd man situations. And by getting back, they're also, once they get the puck, it's D to D. The forwards are back deep enough that they can gain speed as they come up in that regroup situation and really take advantage of other teams' defensemen, which leads to more puck possession.
Linesman Derek Nansen, referee Paul Dvorsky over explaining things to Barry Trotz. The officials corrected themselves, and instead of bringing the faceoff into the Calgary D zone, Bob Hartley will look at one that unfolds right in front of him at center ice. .605 to play in the opening period. Calgary with just five shots on cage to this point against Braden Holtby. Stage in, marked by Burakovsky. Glenn Cross pinned to the wall by Orpik. Brooks Orpik for Burakovsky. Good backtrack by Byron. And then Orpik flattens him. On the rewind, Russell on through Stajan and down. Holtby gets out of the cage and chisels that reverse for Carlson. Another good-looking breakout develops with Brower turned back.
And I like the fact that Burakovsky, instead of going up the wall, comes back with the puck. You know, that was really made a big part of the NHL, those regroups by the Detroit Red Wings when they had that Fab Five. They didn't ever want to dump it in, and that's a good thing. You have puck control, you dump it in, it's too hard to win the pucks back.
Niskanen, who's been on top in terms of the ice time leadership for Washington, didn't get it out. Josh Juris, 24-year-old Ontario native, wears 86 in red. Evgeny Kuznetsov spins one for Chimera. He'll go 2-on-2 with Beagle. Chimera softly towards the cage. Beagle arm-in-arm with Schmid. Locks him up along the boards. Kuznetsov fires. Ramos shrugs it down with a shoulder.
That's an excellent release by Kuznetsov, who's really picked up his game, and that's why he's moved up in the lineup for Barry Trotz for this hockey game. He's skating with more authority, real good release, not overhandling the puck. It's a lot different playing in the KHL than the NHL. There's a good sign by him getting that shot away.
Less than 5 minutes to go in this opening period. Caps and Flames here at Saddle Dome. Washington has a power play strike on the board and the lead on CSN. Our sport fans of the game brought to you by Sport Automotive, Chevrolet and Honda. Be a sport fan too. Visit sportautomotive.com. There's an interesting matchup.
Divided family.
Of course.
Looks like you worked at McDonald's wearing that jersey. Not a fan of that one.
Caps have a 1-0 advantage over the Calgary Flames so far tonight. Joel Ward unassisted on the power play at 11:17 as we are nearing Lattice's intermission live on CSN. Liam O'Brien always in a good-natured mood.
He's been effective so far tonight. Strong in the stick, finishing his hits in the corner, making good plays, not just dumping the puck mindlessly behind the net. He's doing good things, and his work ethic, and it's a team like Calgary that a guy like O'Brien is going to look well and play up to his strengths.
Well, the Caps only, you know, they have four rookies in the lineup, the only team in the NHL that has that. They've got a lot of youth playing here tonight, and has started the season under Trotz.
As the Flames look to build some momentum through center, Raymond closed off by Michael Latta. Puck for Mike Green to his D partner Schmidt. On the lead for Latta, no sale there. Schmid with a good step up. Puck is bouncing all over the place. Late in the period with 3:38 to go in it. Caps will make a line change on the fly. Calgary's in no hurry. Ladislav Schmid lost it to Fair. Fair waiting for Ovechkin, and then Backstrom. Backstrom's drive turned away by Ramos. Monahan stretching his legs down the flank. John Monahan with Hudler going to the goal. Feeds to Colborne. Good defensive work by Fair. Brody will resurface at center with Giordano. 3 minutes to go in the first period.
Caps are doing a great job of taking away the middle of the ice, forcing the Flames to send everything up the wall.
Curtis Glencross, whoa, nearly took the life from referee Kelly Sutherland.
He's had a tough first period.
I'll say. Brody will gather in. 24-year-old Ontario native sends in Byron. And this is offside. Offside against Calgary.
Gonna take a look at some defense early on in this hockey game. Some good plays there. There's Schmidt one-on-one against the dynamic Goudreau. Then Mike Green, a nifty pass through his legs. Brody on OB, couldn't put it through number 7's feet. There's a nice play sprawling as Weidman on the Caps two-on-one. The bad play right there. The only defensive breakdown, a giveaway, and that's why Ward is on the board and the only one here in this game.
Icing call against Calgary with 2.5 to go. In the first, there's your goal scorer. Generating a lot of chances tonight, Joel Ward. Most people don't recall Joel made his NHL debut with Minnesota back in the 06-07 season. Sparkled with Nashville before signing a 4-year deal with the Caps. Weidman bracketed along the boards. Shifting gears back through center. The lead for Glencross is another poor pass. Icing's washed out. Shots on goal unofficially are 9-5 in favor of the Capitals. Alsner peppers that one wide of the cage. Burakovsky didn't feel the bounce. Juris locked up by Johansson. Brower did not appreciate the hit from Stajan. Matt Stajan will swat this one behind Holtby's net. Brower takes Stajan to the boards. He thought he was leg whipped by Stajan. Brower did. He did not like it at all. When he had a chance to get him on the dasher, he did.
Man, he's going to be the only one sent to the box of a roughing minor. Troy Brower heads off. Calgary will have a power play. Ovi's not buying it. Here's the finish of that play. Getting after Stajan up the ice. You mentioned that leg whip that he was very unhappy with. He's going to be sent to the box on a roughing call. And Ovechkin still talking to the referee at center ice, not happy with the non-call that led to that hit along the Capitals bench.
A late first period penalty kill for Barry Trotz's gang. Staked to a 1-0 advantage thanks to a power play goal from Joel Ward. Colborne lost the draw there. This Flames power play at 18.5%, middle of the pack of the NHL. The Caps over 86% in the killing department. 1:25 with which to work in the frame right now. Goudreau joining late for Colborne, then Giordano. Goudreau, good stick check by Carlson. On top it rolls for Brody. Giordano a long way from the cage. Brody winds, screen developing in front. Raymond angles in, off the head fake, no shooting lane. A minute to go in the period now.
There's 1 minute remaining.
Goudreau finds Brody. Slap pass, looking for the deflection. Raymond sent it wide, and Carlson bats it from the crease. Giordano on the dish. Rotation play on now. Giordano, turn it topside. Giordano gets it back, the Flame captain. Brody on the rotation down low. Raymond fires, block. It hit Colborne, a 6'5" screen in front of the net. Colborne settles. Too hot to handle for Raymond, then pinned to the ice by Braden Holtby.
Pretty good puck movement by the Calgary Flames. The Caps unable to clear, leads some threats on the ice. They get a lot of their pop from the point men, guys like Brody, guys like Giordano that could really pound it. Really didn't get any shots through though to Holtby. You look at their power play numbers even last year, not so sparkling. And now without the likes of a guy like Cam O'Leary, they've got to spread around the power play time and look for different guys to score for them.
Holtby's career save percentage among the top five among active netminders. You just saw it there as Hudler dangles for Weidman. Russell with a swing and a miss on the one-timer. 18 seconds in the period. Niskanen, oops, didn't clear. It dribbles back to point position. Weidman bluffs it. Now he'll fire and score.
The Capitals had this baby just about killed off pretty well. They really didn't generate any shots. I mentioned him earlier. There's Niskanen. Can't handle the puck. It goes up the middle, and it's a real nice move. A head fake by Weidman, and watch the cap go wide. Then the slap shot comes, and there it is. Past a stick and a body, Niskanen in front of the net, and Braden Holtby does not pick this up. Might have nicked off him. But they have tied it up late here in the first.
Late means 19:50 of the first period. You're about to hear the siren sound, ending the opening frame. Each team with power play tallies. Joel Ward first, just past the 11-minute mark. And then Dennis Weidman, very late in the final minute of the frame, to level the count at one. First of two meetings in 10 days between these cross-conference rivals. It's 1-1 after 20. Coming up, Lattice Distribution Live. Locker on the road. We'll explain. Highlights and stats, all yours in just a few moments. And in this anniversary season, we'll think back on Dino Cicerelli. Caps and Flames, one-third of the way through regulation. Braden Holtby leading the charge. Flames here at Saddledome, 1-1. Folks, stay tuned. Locker goes mountain climbing in just a moment on Comcast Sportsnet. Beautiful BAM, about an hour and a half away from where Joel Ward and the Washington Capitals are in downtown Calgary tonight. This Saturday evening, north of the border, a 1-1 skirmish with the Calgary Flames, who are in the midst of a lengthy homestand and watching Dennis Weidman score goals in four straight games as he gets all wired up for the second period. We are right there with you. For the NHL on Comcast Sportsnet, Braden Holtby, in two performances a season ago against Calgary, he wouldn't want to have written home about those. He was lifted from the cage in both games. Washington splitting the two with the Flames, who they will see in 10 days' time in our nation's capital. Right off the draw, set play, fair fires, blocking glove save for Kari Rahmo in the cage tonight. Sitting behind him, Jonas Hiller, the former Anaheim Ducks standout.
Who pitched a shutout in their last game and came into this game stopping 99 of the last 101 shots he's faced.
That's pretty darn good. It was a rocking chair 16-save effort against the Hurricanes here on Thursday as Holtby will cover up just 31 seconds into period two.
Yeah, Braden obviously starting five of the first six. I would think that they would start Peters tomorrow against the Vancouver Canucks coming off a lengthy road trip. They got smacked around a little bit last night, but Peters, when he has come in, has performed admirably for this Caps team.
Justin Peters with a victory at Florida's expense back on home ice. Capitals will return to play at Verizon. They'll entertain the Detroit Red Wings this coming Wednesday. Andrei Burakovsky will send it in. Rahmo keeps it moving. Two teams at even in full strength. Rahmo makes the save on the long drive from Alsman. The rebound is loose, and then Rahmo jabs that away. Burakovsky dangerous for Washington.
He had three chances in front of the net. The puck comes to great players, and it comes to number 65. He could have easily put the Caps up by a goal once again.
And that's all started by Kerr Alsner holding the line and sending that puck to the net. Whether it was wobbling or not, you get those pucks down deep, you get players in front.
Weidman's pass goes awry. It'll chase Ladislav Schmid all the way back into his own zone, the 28-year-old native of the Czech Republic. Stationed at center, it's Schmidt on the dump down. Johnny Gaudreau, double team. Beagle gets help from Chimera on top green. Rister didn't get through the traffic. Schmid on the intercept goes indirect for Gaudreau, three on three. Backlund closing. Timing play, looking for Raymond at the post. It never arrived. Chimera goes out wide for Green, getting up into the rush. Ramo makes the pad save. Mike Green and Kari Ramo forever linked in the NHL history books. Raymond on the overlap. Goudreau closing. A poke check made by Green. Back in the 08-09 season, Green scored goals in 8 straight games, a record for an NHL defender. And the record was set in Tampa Bay against Kari Ramo. Englund, the former Penguin, on through Jurison down.
Yeah, a lot of the Penguins got out of Pittsburgh, didn't they?
Sure, it looks like it. Yeah. They're having a reunion tonight.
They had two on the Caps and one there, big tough guy Englund playing for Calgary.
Rafael Diaz, a healthy scratch, as Ward closes into the backhand, he just missed. And then he went hurtling into the cage, knocking the net from its moorings.
What a great play by Michael Latta on the blue line entry. Everyone looks and thinks he's going to his left wing. He's patient with the puck, does the fake move and gets it to Ward, who's driving, who just loses it. And I can't believe that there's not a penalty on that play.
And Barakovsky earlier in this period, one chance, two chances, and actually the puck's going to bounce to him again right there. Three chances, great opportunity. In the corner, Mojo takes a high stick, again undetected by the refereeing crew, and he is furious, as were the Capitals coaches on the bench, as Mojo may have to have a repair done to his face.
Capitals were incensed with a couple of leg checks, trips that they thought should have been assessed from referees Dvorsky and Sutherland, a veteran pair in the orange armbands. Neither of those calls, one against Ovechkin, one against Brouwer, were assessed. A little bit shy of the 3-minute mark in the second period. If you're just tuning in with us, power play goals back in the first. Ward for Washington, Weidman for the Flames. Joe Beninati, Craig Laughlin upstairs. Alan May inside the glass for you with the NHL on CSN as we thank all the men and women in our technical crew tonight. One and only visit to Scotiabank Saddle Dome. And once again, the Caps get it done early in the year.
Ouch.
Ovechkin took that blast from Byron. Bouncing right back to his skates and gets up into the rush. Counter-punching. Stajent to Glenn Cross. He whistles one wide off of Orpik.
Man, that was off the side of his body and his left hand, Joe. Another sacrifice in front by OV, blocking a shot. We've seen more blocks from OV under Trotz than we did before, right off the start of the season. And that one's going to sting, not only the leg, but I think it caught his left hand to boot.
34-year-old Brooks Orpik ahead. 19-year-old Burakovsky stacked up at the attacking line by Chris Russell. Marcus Johansson, none the worse for wear, able to dump it in. Johansson chasing after a puck. Hudler golfs it to center. The ricochet off of Alsner picked up on the move by Colborne. On around, Weidman steps in from point position. Keeping the cycle humming. Weidman fires through the screen. It deflected wide.
Lucky it hit the butt of number two Niskanen, or that could have been headed into the net past the blocker.
In tight quarters through center, Russell gathers in. Weidman will give some ground, stalked by Johansson. Dennis Weidman played his junior hockey in London. In the OHL, Kuznetsov with a takeaway, backhand bid. Ramo makes two pad saves on Jay Beagle.
Monahan, some bad puck work down low. Luckily for him, he's got Ramo and net saving his bacon.
Whistle and a stoppage in play. The faceoff will come in neutral zone as we revisit the fray around the Calgary net.
Yeah, here it is coming up. Ripped off right there. Good job, Beagle. Good backhand. Another opportunity in front. Great chance for Kuznetsov and company. And here's that block by Alex Ovechkin laying out against Byron. Here he is getting ready, goes down on the one knee, left side of the body, and there he is taking his glove off with that left hand going to the bench.
There have been 8 shots taken in the second period so far. Shy of the 5-minute mark, and the Caps have sent 7 of them on goal as Holtby tees it up for a turning Mike Green. Kuznetsov's pass was not a good one. Englund launching it back on through Raymond and down.
Well, if you like a flow game, you're probably not going to like this one, Joe. Not a whole lot of flow, just a grinding, hard working hockey game. It's going to be one along the wall here tonight.
It hasn't been a work of art. Englund towards a cage, stick save, Holtby. Rebound taken off the dasher by Beagle. Skating extremely well. He was telling you he's lighter these days than he has been in seasons past.
Man, you can add that step to your game if you have that type of physical play when you're lighter. And obviously Beagle, one of the hardest workers for this Caps team as far as off-season conditioning.
Lana to the front, backhand score! Joel Ward!
And Michael Latta, once again, what an effort on the board to keep that puck in, get it, grind it, and get it into the crease. And Joel Ward going exactly where he needed to. But Michael Latta, some shifty work here on the wall to get the puck through. I love when players charge the paint, and Joel Ward, it pays off for the Caps big time.
Man, Schmid couldn't get the stick on puck to knock it away, and Joel Ward could easily have had a hat trick. Here's a nice isolation of Ward, and it's a nifty backhander. He missed on one on a semi-breakaway earlier on in the period, but there he makes sure he wraps it around the right toe of the goaltender, Ramo. Caps have a 2-1 lead.
Is there a fifth line they could put Joel Ward on? Keep dropping him down the roster, he'll score more goals.
All smiles there with Liam O'Brien. Joel Ward's fourth on the season, second on the night. Primary assist to Latta at 5:41. And the Caps have the advantage back. Nicklas Backstrom, fresh from his 500th point in the NHL. It occurred when the Caps were last in action in Edmonton Wednesday. A 3-2 loss in regulation time as Carlson occupies Bolig. This is offside against the Flames. Power play goals back in the first. This one's an even strength tally. Both of them for Joel Ward on the board. Has the Caps out in front. Flames fans enjoying their weekend inside of Saddle Dome. Washington has come to town and taken a 2-1 advantage on a pair of strikes from Joel Ward. We get set to resume second period action. These guys in white, right back at it tomorrow against Vancouver. Just the third home game of the season for the Canucks. Backstrom beat Stajan on the draw. Two teams are skating 5-on-5. Brody on the headman, snared by Ovechkin. Alex Ovechkin darting wide, was upset there by Stajan. This was offside on the rush.
Real good defensive play by the grade 8. He's blocked the shot, he's had some chances, but there was all team defense. He was waiting in the weeds just outside the blue line, read the play perfectly as Stajan and company tried to quick up. It's a ripoff. And here's Alex. Here's an isolation of Alex. Look at him make sure he's back-checking. He rewinds in a hurry, a little bit offside. Real good effort by the Capitals captain.
A little bit offside?
A little bit.
Dennis Wideman will give some ground and send it out there wide for Chris Russell. Hudler keeping it moving down the flank. Monahan to greet Alsner. Carl Alsner out of the defensive zone, the former Calgary Hitmen captain. He was the best defenseman in all of junior hockey when he played here. Hudler through center. Snared by Alsner, who makes his home in these parts in the summer. Russell on the accelerator, clears in. Braden Holtby given a one-goal lead to protect. An early second frame marker from Joel Ward. Turning back through center, Goudreau, all 150 pounds of him. Darting wide on the backhand off the outside of the cage.
I'm not sure that's the truth, though.
150, you're not banking on that?
No, I think 140.
They list him at 160.
Okay.
Goudreau turns the corner, feeds it on top. Englund switch it up for Schmid. Beagle was in the shooting lane. Kuznetsov puts the pressure on. Goudreau gets the screen set from Backlund to the front. Backlund denied by Holtby. Alsner lifts it along the dasher, not out yet. Good shift for Raymond, Goudreau, and Backlund.
The puck just seems to follow Goudreau around everywhere he's at. He's got incredible vision. He's kind of a choppy skater, but the puck is always on his stick. And if you're out with him, it's almost like Kuznetsov, Backstrom. Those are the kind of guys, always have your stick ready for a shot on net when those guys are on the ice with you.
The Russell pass came on through. Bolig finished off by Alsner. Bolig tries to stuff it, came right through the paint. Beagle needs to get it out for Washington. Strong on the puck through center. He'll clear in. Weidman sends it right up the gut. Boma closing in against his former Bantam teammate, Braden Holtby in the Nets. Holtby about a 5 hours drive from his home base in Lloydminster, Saskatchewan. Russell with his head up. Down the wing. Glenn Cross inside for Boma. Undercut there by Ward.
Yeah, good back check by Ward. You always track up the middle and wait for the puck to come there, and that's exactly what Wardo did.
Weidman with a goal for Calgary. Sends it right to the glove, but this is offside against the Flames. On the Toyota League leaderboard, these teams have the puck more than most.
Yeah, we're talking about Corsi numbers and five-on-five close opportunities. Minnesota, Chicago, Washington, close to 55%, fourth overall. The teams on that list have a combined record of 16-10-4. It's important to have the puck. I thought the Caps were tremendous the other night against Edmonton. Their Corsi was above 55, as was their Penguins, right around that same number. They had the puck way more than the Oilers did on their last game.
And the real reason for that, Locker, is that the Capitals' defense, and you look at all those other teams in the top with Corsi ratings, is their defensemen are moving the puck to players, they're passing tape to tape, they're staying involved and activating in the offensive zone rather than backing off and letting odd man rushes come their way. They're forcing the puck back behind the net, making plays and shooting the puck when they have. And the biggest change in the Capitals' defensive roster is Carl Hulsner. What he's been able to do with the puck has been exceptional compared to where he's played the last few years in backing off.
Stage in 2-on-2, working out wide. Pass came right on through. Brody got up trying to make it an odd man rush. As we near the midway mark of regulation time, the Capitals have a 2-1 advantage. Backstrom feathers it ahead. Too strong for Fair. Green will reorganize. Bob Hartley wants to get some fresh folks out there for the Flames. Green's pass deflected by Hudler. He'll propel on for Monahan. Schmidt was in that skating lane. Ovechkin barreling in. Brody lost his balance. Green is waiting. Colburn put an arm on him. Giordano for Calgary. Off the boards and out. Brooks Orpik, who picked up an assist on the second period goal for Joel Ward. Orpik had a couple of helpers against New Jersey back home. Get a whistle and a stoppage in play with 9:54 to go. Second period. And Washington on top. Burakovsky likes it that way on CSN. Capitals have taken two of their last three. They've got a 2-1 lead over the Flames north of the border. The assist leaders are presented by your local Hyundai dealers. Let them assist you in scoring the lowest prices on the hottest lineup in America. These are the best of the freshman feeders.
Philip Forsberg in Nashville leads two better than Burakovsky. Kuznetsov, Percy, and Duclair all in the top five. All nice-looking young rookies. Two caps in that category. That's a good thing.
Evgeny Kuznetsov with assists in three of his last five outings. Back on a one-hander. Stopped by Holtby. Goudreau lurking behind the net. Orpik takes down Mason Raymond. Penalty call coming up. Russell lines and fires. Glove save Holtby as the Flames go to the power play.
Yeah, it's going to be a trip to Brooks Orpik. Mason Raymond in the corner, very quick and elusive, trying to get skate down low. And the assistant captain, Brooks Orpik's going to head off on a minor penalty. Tripping, power play upcoming for Dennis Weidman and his troops. So they go to the power play. Here it is down low. Watch the quickness. Goudreau, a little kick pass, and there's that spin of Mason Raymond, who has 5 goals and 7 points so far this season.
Calgary skating 5-on-4, trailing by 1. These power play stats are packaged by the UPS store. Giordano on the one-timer, that's deflected away. Flames were 0-for-2 in their win against Carolina Thursday. Giordano leans into a blast and caroms wide of the goal. The Weidman first period tally, a man up. Brody. Hudler. Glenn Cross down low, looking to Monahan, that's steered aside. Joel Ward, both goals for Washington tonight. Scampers through center and then delays before dumping it in.
That was a quick 3-on-2, real good counter by the Caps. They failed to clear once. We're getting it out to hurry the second time. They had an automatic break.
Hudler sends in for Glenn Cross, closed down by Mike Green. Russell to Brody. Lines in, fires, stopped by Holtby. Rebound loose at the doorstep, it trickles wide. Monahan with good composure. Sean Monahan, the second-year pro. Hoodler on the interchange. Good stick check there by Niskanen, and it's dealt on down by Jay Beagle, the Calgary native.
A lot of great work by both Niskanen and Green on that shift down low. Both active sticks, getting involved, taking away the time and the space, and getting all over that puck so the Flames couldn't make any crisp, clean plays.
Raymond offside on the rush for the Flames. McDonald's trivia question for you tonight, folks. Concerning Calgary Flame history, which two players tied with the most career hat tricks in Calgary Flames history? This, their most recent season of NHL festivities, Washington's 40th anniversary campaign. Think big goal scorers in Flame history. But there's always a twist. There's always a wrinkle. Russell charging back. Dangerous pass there with Kuznetsov lying in wait. Flames will enter the zone. Still a man up for 8 seconds. Colburn had that one come through him. Russell has the puck. Shimmies past Kuznetsov and fires one off of Carlson and wide. John Carlson has the puck to capture back to full strength. Morpik's out of the box. Goudreau, the Hobie Baker Award winner out of Boston College. College hockey's equivalent of the Heisman Trophy.
He doesn't have to have a whole lot of room to turn, does he?
I think that's why his coach called him a rattlesnake this morning.
Yeah.
And he meant it in a good way.
When he's got the puck, he's allowed to be a dipsy doodle and a rattlesnake, but when he doesn't, he has to listen to old Bob,
and he
had for his exact words.
And he had to make sure he doesn't get on the nerves of Bob, because Bob didn't like his two-minute shifts that he had in college.
Some were longer than that.
Yeah.
Boma overskates. Backstrom has it, and this is going to be an offside against the Flames. This from the promotions department. The 2015 Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic, January 1, 2015 at Nationals Park. For more information on how to guarantee access to tickets, call 202-266-CAPS or visit WashingtonCaps.com.
Guys, one of my favorite moments so far this road trip was sitting with you two guys and Bob Hartley this morning at the Flames pregame skate. And it what a guy. I never realized he was that funny, and I didn't know you were that scared of him, Joby. That was hysterical this morning.
We have a history with him. That's all.
Just reminiscing.
Incredible. It was awesome.
That's why I brought muscle on this trip, namely Alan May, just in case. Schmidt for Green, blocked off by Glenn Cross. Stajan has the puck for Calgary. Nice pass to Byron, relayed on to Brody, but offside once more. This game has been littered with offside infraction.
And I think it's because both teams are really holding their own lines very well, and you're trying to make passes and going under control. And if you take one stutter step, you throw everybody offside. And that's been the case between the two blue lines here for Fair, Giordano and company in this second period.
Just to go back to what Alan May was referring to, we've made peace with Bob Hartley. All is well. We were back in his good graces a long time ago.
He says he likes us both now, Joe.
That goes back to Thrasher Capital days in a Donnybrook in D.C. At a point position, it's Raymond leading the Flames in goals, along with Dennis Weidman now, who has his fifth back in the first period. Caps with a pair from Joel Ward. Numbers 3 and 4 on the young season. Johansson to Burakovsky. He's got points in 5 of 6 on the dump in. Brower waiting. Angled and finished by Weidman. This one's on the lip of the boards for a while. Brower. The pass that didn't come through. Goudreau just ladles it in. Flames want to change. Niskanen coughed it up. That's Russell in deep. With 5.5 separating us from Lattice's intermission live. They jam for the puck to the left of Braden Holtby, who watches England maneuver at the line. Colborne, saucer pass, England's drive, head high, wide of the cage. Monahan to Hoodler. Hoodler with the defenders hung up. It's jammed wide by Schmid. A well-timed pinch from the point. Orpik dragging it loose off the boards, but not out yet. England outside Colborne. Monahan fires a dominating shift here for the Flames. The ricochet will chase him back to center.
Well, that's their game, and everyone knows it. They get you cycling. They throw pucks to the net. They keep things simple down low.
Juris fires with a good snapshot, and it's juggled into the glove off the pad by Braden Holtby. Still 2-1 Washington. Back for the conclusion of period two in a moment. Batter up Alex Ovechkin. The hard hits. Highlights of the game brought to you by Timberland Pro.
Running over the referee, Sutherland, along the wall there. Hartley said if you want to play physical against Ovechkin, you better get in the gym for about 2 weeks prior. There he is, tripped up. There he is, blocking a shot. A lot of hard hits. A lot of them doled out by OV. That last one, captain on captain.
Alex Ovechkin needs half a dozen points to pass Peter Bonner on the all-time point scoring list for the Capitals as Giordano has to retreat to center. TJ Brody lends a helping hockey stick. Even in full strength with 4.5 to go in the middle frame. The NHL on Comcast Sportsnet tonight. We'll be with you again tomorrow. Habs and Canucks, remember that's a 9:30 Eastern time start. The boys had best remember that it's a 6:30 start yeah. In Vancouver.
Yeah, and Vancouver Canucks, wholesale changes throughout their lineup, including their netminder, Mr. Miller, who I would think would play against Ovechkin in the Caps tomorrow.
Definitely. It was Eddie Lack, who was throttled pretty good by the Colorado Avalanche last night. Glenn Cross, twice a 20-goal scorer in his NHL career. Now 7 seasons for him in Calgary.
He likes it out here. He's a chuck wagon racer.
Really?
Yeah. You have to live out here if you're going to do that.
Giordano stalked by Ovechkin. Colborne tried to tap it through Carlson as Hudler sends it to the cage where Holtby will swing. Shots on goal at the moment. 19-14 favor Washington. Backstrom stalled to the line, sends it hard around. It finds Ovechkin. Didn't stay on his tape long as Barry Trotz wants the line change. Washington missing the services of Brooks Light, John Erskine, Tom Wilson, Aaron Volpatti, and Dmitry Orlov. With Tom Wilson getting into AHL duty with the Hershey Bears last night.
Yeah, took the loss 4-2 against Lehigh Valley, but he played well, got some hits, some bumps, got his legs going. It's not in the third period. The coaching staff said he looked a little weary and tired. They expect him to play once again tomorrow after practice today.
Jack Hillen and Chris Brown, the healthy scratches for Washington on the trip with the team and watching from on high at Saddledome.
And way hit high, Joe, in that game by Jake Rosell. Took an elbow and left that game.
Never good. Weidman able to keep that in. Raymond occupied by Ward. Mason Raymond, beautiful stick handling, fires that one off the shin guards of Ward. Latta, who set up the lead goal for Washington in this period, skies one into the flame zone. Weidman carefully out of his own territory. Plays the game at his pace, doesn't he?
Yeah, which is not fast.
Oh. Juris took a hard hit. Carlson on the tap-tap passing for Beagle. Chimera gets in there first. Beagle off the interchange. Carlson's drive, a missile that went wide.
Oh!
And then Orpik just destroyed Juris. Gloves are down. Bullock's throwing punches. Orpik is the man with whom he's upset.
Juris is wobbling with the referee, Joe. He was run over by a freight train named Brooks Orpik. All the way up the ice, by the way, Orpik's stick was caught in Juris's pads and jersey. And then at the end, he runs him over at the blue line as Juris tries to poke it out of the zone. Out of this, the Caps should have a power play, but a heavy, heavy collision.
Actually, Locker on that, they were going to call Orpik on that hit on the pinch in, and it comes in as the puck comes around the wall here. Well, that's the original hit. Juris puts himself, he puts himself in a bad situation. There's no penalty there. They go down the ice, but it's coming up at the far blue line as they go into the zone and the puck comes around. Orpik comes up, and finishes him. And I don't think he leaves his feet until after the hit, but I think they're going to call him for leaving his feet on that. And then Bolig runs in there and gets the indicator. So if anything, that should be even.
Alan, that's a tough one for Brooks Orbit because Juris is folded in half. He's bent halfway down.
Well, he put himself in that position twice, here in the far end behind Holtby, and then in the far end at the blue line. He's got to do a better job of protecting himself. And, you know, everyone knows that Brooks Orpik's job is to finish his hits, to be involved. And when you play against a guy like that, you have to have your head up. You've got to be prepared to take the body every single time.
Alan, Brooks Orpik tonight with 7 hits before the game is 40 minutes old.
Well, he lets you know he's there. Every single time you go in the corner, every single time in front of the net, he's going to get a piece of your body, and he's a massive human being, and he puts a lot into that body contact. And like I said, he's one of those guys you have to be very, very aware of at all times. When I played, there was a guy like Brian Marchman, and you had to keep an eye on him. You had to know where he was on the bench, where he's in the penalty box, and certainly when he was on the ice.
Referee Kelly Sutherland giving Barry Trotz an explanation. We have not. I'm looking at all around. I've only seen a 2-minute penalty up on the board to Brooks Orpik. I find it in the end zone, not on the main clock. Here's the second hit. Watch how low Juris is.
Yeah, it's a wraparound. You just see Orpik come in, makes contact. Sort of look like a Nick Cronwall hit. See a lot of those in Detroit, right?
Only Cronwall does it with his wallet from his backside. Liam O'Brien will serve. The Caps and Flames.
Oh, they're safe. Four on four. Yeah.
That's what we're seeing. Penalty time is on the Brooks Orpik side. Don't see 2 minutes up on the Calgary side just yet.
And that's why they're trying to sort it out.
Bob Hartley with a nod of the head, the head coach here in Calgary. Third year as the boss of the Flames. Won a Stanley Cup in 2001 with the Colorado Avalanche. And 4 years with the Atlanta Thrashers. In the old Southeast, Sutherland gets an earful from the timekeeper's bench. We're just about to resume the second period.
Whoa, could have had a couple of commercials in that time.
Then he ran into one of the Flames getting back into position. Now we got it sorted out.
Lattice's intermission live coming up. Carlson, Niskanen, Ovechkin, Backstrom, 4 on the ice and white for Washington. Ovechkin behind the back to Backstrom, the centering pass that's an aerial. Ovechkin was undercut along the boards. Brody steps out of his own zone. Giordano there too. Gets the line and hits the brakes. Colborn will keep it in. No, not really. He'll have to reverse through center. Tripped up by Backstrom. Monahan will dump it. Braden Holtby gets into the act. And then Matt Niskanen will start the breakout. 27-year-old Virginia, Minnesota native. Niskanen through center on the zigzag. Not much there for him. Ovechkin and Carlson in tight quarters. Backstrom out wide. 1:15 with which to work in period two. The lone tally in the frame. Joel Ward's second on the night. Brower full speed ahead. Burakovsky snapshot stopped by Ramo, and he'll melt the rebound. Washington has the 2-1 advantage. Hadid has the road ahead for the Caps.
And right after tomorrow night in Vancouver, the Caps will play the Canucks, 9:30 Eastern. Wednesday, it's covered nationally on NBCSN versus the Red Wings. Saturday, we're at the Lightning and right back home for a Sunday night against the Arizona Coyotes at 7 at Verizon.
And then the rematch in 10 days' time with these Calgary Flames. Final minute of period two, Chris Russell was triple team there. Brower leisurely through center. Troy Brower waiting for some reinforcements. Alsner sprinkles that one wide of the cage. 40 seconds in the second period. Mike Green in his hometown for Burakovsky. Born in Austria, raised in Sweden. Andre Burakovsky steps in. Nice pass. Brower fires. It's punched down by Ramo. Burakovsky, slick stick handling, manages to keep it in. Brower with 15 seconds to go in the period. Alsner thought about it. Green, he'll take it right to the chest of Ramo. There's no rebound.
What a shift for number 65. Just terrific. Coming out of the box, O'Brien and Boleg being escorted to the bench. Saw O'Brien talking a lot to Boleg after he took exception to that hit by the Capitals' Orpik. And O'Brien, a lot of chit-chatting with Boleg. They may be going if they get out together in the third period.
Boleg, thank you, tips the scales around 225.
Thank you.
Final 10 seconds of period two. Fair to take this draw. Stajan controlled it. 5 seconds to go. Brody knocked down. As the puck rolls to center, the second period is complete. After 40 minutes tonight, Braden Holtby has a lead. He and the Caps are aiming for their fourth win of the season. Joel Ward has both goals for Washington. The only one in the second period at the 5:41 mark. Lattices Intermission Live takes a look at current Caps Vice President and GM Brian McClellan and his days with the Flames. Highlights and stats from here in the booth. Locker will telestrate if we beg enough. He'll break out more of those stretchy arrows for us. Through two in Calgary at Saddle Dome. Washington has the lead. Chris Miles with this Geico Sportsnet Central update. This Comcast Sportsnet coverage of Capitals hockey is being brought to you by your Washington area Chevy dealers. Find your local dealer on ChevyFirst.com. 84 Lumber. Get your project started today at 84lumber.com. And by Toyota. Check out the bold new 2015 Camry and visit buyatoyota.com for offers. Gotta love the mountain air in Banff. Some of us on this broadcast team loved it a bit too much. Apparently, it went right to their head. Caps have a 2-1 advantage over the Flames through 40 minutes worth of work in front of the young hockey fans on a Saturday night. It's the 40th anniversary for the Washington Capitals and a fan favorite, Dino Cicerelli.
I'm going to try to be better on this one, buddy. 608 goals, 1,200 points in his career. His office was the front of the net. Wasn't the biggest guy. He'd take a beating to score a goal. He absolutely loved to score. With his four seasons with the Caps, he had a 41 and a 38 goal season. Huge goals. I call him Mr. Big. He was always around the net. When you needed a big goal, Dino put it home.
These numbers for Cicerelli on his resume, quite impressive, a 2010 Hockey Hall of Famer.
Yeah, acquired by the Caps and the North Stars for Bob Rouse, Mike Gartner, and Larry Murphy. So they got Rouse and Dino. We sent Gartner and Murphy to Minnesota and the North Stars.
Caps and Flames tonight. Joel Ward's hogging the headlines, hogging the score sheet. A couple of goals for Joel tonight. Washington, the one-goal lead, heading to the third. On Twitter, which Caps player would you most want to hang out with for a day in D.C.?
Niskanen.
Bonding over life in Northern Mini.
Hang out with Alan May. I grew up watching him scrap and would love to go out with him. Chill with Holtby, Prairie Boys.
Peter Bondra. Reason why that Caps fan fell in love with the game. Oh, Vespa. Greeny, all different types of modes of transportation for Mike Green.
Yeah, likes the fast cars, likes the Vespa, but now he's turning his attention to an old Volkswagen Trailmaster, the ones that you take and you can camp inside of them. Pretty cool.
Dad Dave in attendance, Mom Kate just the same. Big numbers of supporters for the Cavs. From the Green family, from the Beagle family, as Niskanen fires. That's rejected by Matt Stajan. We get going in the third, a low-scoring affair between these two squads.
I asked Mr. Green if he was coming to Vancouver to watch the game. He says, no, I'm too busy. I said, I thought you were retired. Yes, I'm busy in retirement. I can't come tomorrow night.
That's exactly what he said to us while we were watching the Caps practice at Winsport on a stretch here for Backstrom. One-on-one with a wrist, he scores! Nicklas Backstrom, sleight of hand.
Used the defenseman as a screen. Chris Russell, who led everybody in ice time through 40 minutes, and he used his legs to rip it between them and beat the goaltender glove side. Nick Backstrom on the board. Great way to start a period. Just 41 seconds in. Starts with a stretch pass, and there's the shot. Barry Trotz is going to love that because he thought early in the season the Caps were a pass-first team rather than shoot. And now he's shooting, and that pays dividends for Nick Backstrom. Caps have a two-goal lead.
And what a shot through the legs of Chris Russell. And the other thing that you mentioned, that stretch pass, what a great pass by Carl Alsner. In the past, he just wraps that up the board. Today, he makes the great pass to Nick Backstrom. And I can't say enough about Carl, the changes in his game right now, how much is helping the Caps with puck possession and creating time in the other team's end.
In the other team's end, that's where you'll find Jason Chmerin, Jay Beagle, as well as Evgeny Kuznetsov. Colborne answering back for the Flames. A 3-1 lead now for Washington. Backstrom's second of the season. He had a tally against New Jersey earlier in the campaign on a tip-in. Beagle waltzes ahead, plays it down the wall for Chmerin. Dennis Weidman for the Flames on the outlet. Backstrom now with points in five of his last six games. Washington with a two-goal cushion. Green has the puck. A 75-footer that goes wide of the net. Burakovsky, clothesline there by England. Back through center, Goudreau scuttles it into the corner. Raymond gives chase. Backlund, the Swede, on top for England. This way to Schmid, wide of the goal. Brouwer with a good lift check. Troy Brouwer then poke checked by England. Just past the witching hour back home. Joe Beninati, Craig Laughlin, Alan May with you tonight. It's the NHL on Comcast Sportsnet. First of two meetings between these two. They'll see each other again on the 4th of November. Joel Ward with a pair of goals. Nicholas Backstrom off to a flying start here in the third. It's 3-1 DC. Green sends in. Giordano. For Boma. Content to dump it in. It deflects out of play.
Good job by Niskanen standing up at the blue line there. Little shot Boley giving a shot by O'Brien. Once again, we saw them talk and chatter at the bench. There you see the first signs that this may happen. And there's Michael Latta also getting involved with their tough guy. Buma can throw him, but they're really going after Boley, and it's all O'Brien.
He's not hitting.
Lance Boma making his way back to the bench. Liam O'Brien stays out there for Washington. O'Brien already this season is scrapped with Brandon Preston. Matt Hendricks, the former Cap, with whom O'Brien danced on Wednesday at Rexall Place. Carl Alsner and Matt Niskanen picked up the assists on the early Backstrom third period goal. It is Niskanen who will play clear off the glass. Stajan revolving back with Glenn Cross one-on-one. He fires. That was muffled by Niskanen. Chris Russell from skate to stick. South of the goal line for Glenn Cross. Interceding there was Niskanen with help and support from Latta. Washington's away. This is an icing call against the visiting Caps. Friends, you can stay up to date on your favorite team. Download the new CSN Washington app today. It features breaking news, instant analysis, scores, and now video. Get everything Capitals, Redskins, Wizards, DC United, and more right now on the new CSN Washington app. Guys in the white jerseys are pleased with what they have seen transpire thus far. A date with Vancouver looming tomorrow. Giordano fires. That was blocked by Ward. Brody shimmying free from the check of Alsner, coughed it up. And Latta will get that center line and dump in so Barry Trotz can make a line change. Hudler on target for Brody. Long strides into the offensive end. He sends it wide of Braden Holtby. To this point with 14 stops on his ledger. Backstrom is forced by Monahan. Colborn goes after his opposite number 8, Alex Ovechkin. Soccer style on for Backstrom and ahead to Fair. Eric Fair's pass deflected by Brody, an active stick. Monahan lifts it ahead. Carlson was ready at the attacking line. Fair with a nice pass to himself off the boards. Towards the goal, guarded by Kari Ramo. Fair, uncontested, fires. Ramo got the blocker on that. Fair has his own rebound. Ovechkin with a quick one-touch pass. Taking that away was Weidman. Giordano on for Monahan and off the boards and out. Bob Hartley wants to get some fresh folks out there. Goudreau stopped by Beagle on the head man for Chimera. Drops it into the corner. Kuznetsov was lurking in the slot. He's been the center flanking Beagle and Chimera all night long. Jason's pass to the front, intercepted by Russell.
Yeah, it looks like from up here, that goal by Backstrom really has deflated this hockey team.
Stuff attempt twice from Beagle. Going to the full split was Ramo, and then the net is off of its moorings.
Good stuff opportunity. The Caps really controlling play after that early Backstrom goal, getting the puck in deep, getting it around the net. Here's the hard work down low. Nice play by Beagle. There's the stuff, a couple of whacks. Watch at the end of that. You'll see a plane fly right into the goalpost. Watch this. Boom. That stops the play. That's Chris Russell as the puck is still alive in front of Kari Ramo.
Ramo displaying his flexibility.
Yeah.
Face-off win back for Alsner's wrister, and Ramo gets the glove on that.
That was a good save right there. Wasn't it him and Rito Barra last year? And then they dealt him to Colorado, and they brought in their backup, or their number one guy, Jonas Hiller, you could say.
32-year-old from Switzerland, Hiller, who had a 49-save gem in an overtime win over Chicago recently. Alsner keeping it on the perimeter. Brouwer was stopped in his tracks by Stajan. Those two were upset with each other earlier in the night. Alsner shovels it on around for Niskanen. Off the bounce to the corner, there's Burakovsky. Johansson through center. Clears in. To the glass and boards. Schmid was there with the contact. And now he has the puck. Vladislav Schmid. Czech Olympian in Sochi back in 2014. Giordano closing in, fires, and there's Holtby deep in the paint with a puck to his chest. Coors Light, cold hard fact, brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light.
And it's all about Alex Ovechkin, points per game in his career versus Calgary. Small quantity of games, but close to two versus the Ducks, 1.67. St. Louis above 1.5. Winnipeg and Toronto not far behind. And you can say three of the top five teams there, Joby, are Canadian teams, where he seems to just score at will against these Canadian teams.
Loves to play on the big stage, does Alex Ovechkin. Backlund preparing to take the draw against fellow Swede Nicklas Backstrom. Backlund's excused from the dot. Ovechkin's off to the races. Alex Ovechkin gets to the interior, and Backlund was waiting for him. Caps have a 3-1 lead. Backstrom on the board early in the third as Green works wide on Giordano to the front. Off the cage to the hockey stick of Bowling, and then he coughed it up. Schmidt sends in for Ovechkin. Alex needs a breather. Brody swivels away from Eric Fair with a long reach, pestering him through center. Fair works in. Weidman for Colburn on the exit. Picking up speed. Straightened up by Green. 5-on-5 in the D zone now for Washington. Weidman, the lone goal scorer for the Flames. He's got tallies at 4 straight. Hudler, marked by Orpik. Weidman winds, fakes. Russell fires. Glove save routine for Holtby. With some more pushing and shoving in front. Exactly 7 minutes into the third. It's the Caps by 2 on Comcast Sportsnet. This game summary brought to you by Nightpoint Systems. They offer the technology you need when you need it. Joel Ward doubling his pleasure tonight.
The blue line board gets a lot of goals for the Calgary Flames. This one, Dennis Wiedemann up last. Four-game goal scoring streak continues, and Nicholas Backstrom has his second goal of the season, his 129th goal of his career. That's our game summary here tonight in Calgary.
Joel Ward and Alex Ovechkin looking on eagerly as we resume play in the third. Just less than 13 minutes with which to work in this final frame. Calgary Flames, they'll play host to Montreal on Tuesday. Caps get right back to work tomorrow in Vancouver. Hudler to the front, answered by Orpik, who's played a stout game tonight. Run to the ditch there by Hudler. On a break, it's Kuznetsov. Snapshot deflected by Brody and out of play. 3-1, Washington has the advantage. Alan May is inside the glass.
Hey guys, from my vantage point back here all night, I've been so impressed with the Capitals and what they've been doing. The back pressure exhibited by the forwards on the back check, and then the defenseman able to hold up the line. Crisp pucks turned back this way, and then the grind in the corner in the offensive zone. All of the Caps, all four lines have been doing a good job of working the Flames below the goal line. Pretty stingy with the puck, but very impressive with all of their play tonight.
They're putting a force field up, Allen, in front of Braden Holtby. As Fair will clear it in. The Caps have allowed the fewest shots on goal of any team in the East so far in this young season. Niskanen guns it right off of Wiedemann. The ricochet on the blade of Backstrom, and the Caps will be content to rag time now. That scoreboard clock is their ally north of the border in Calgary. Russell pivots for Stajan. Glencross has the puck, 2-on-2. Juris, the snapshot. Bob Hartley's a big fan of number 86's release. Halsner ahead for Fair, trundles it to center. Giordano, bit out of the reach of Glencross, who gave Burakovsky a slash. That was nice of him. Schmidt rewinding with Niskanen. Matt Niskanen on the head man to Brouwer. Giordano is in his skating lane. Burakovsky takes it off the boards. Johansson comes to help. It'll get past Green. He'll need to rewind at center. This is going to be an offside call against Washington.
That slap shot from Schmidt hit Brouwer inside the blue line. Therefore, the offsides call. Troy Brouwer and his boys, a day off in Calgary where they had a chance to do a little curling, and not too happy with that last offsides as he hits the bench.
The Jeep shots on goal into thirds. Caps having the shots on goal advantage. Nicholas Backstrom told us in the recent days here while the club was off that the off day was fantastic. Really enjoyed it. You don't get very many opportunities to do that as a club on the road. Ward steps in. Green fires, deflected wide of the cage, and the commissioner of the curling tournament, the head coach of the Caps, has to be thrilled so far with what he's seen. That's Barry Trotz.
Yeah, I really like it.
Latta muscled by England. O'Brien to the front. That's chiseled away. Latta station to station. O'Brien looks to stuff. Rebounds loose at the top of the paint. And the Flames come out of there. Raymond darting down the wing. Green takes care of him. Schmidt. Pressure comes from Backlund. Backlund was an alternate captain on a World Junior team with Marcus Johansson. Wiedemann swings it ahead. Bolig distributes. Boma and Backlund didn't get through Carlson or Beagle.
No, that's where they've had the toughest time. They've been turning it over consistently at the Capitals' blue line or just chipping it in. And the Capitals have had a heyday moving the puck out of the zone and stalling their rushes here tonight.
Holtby then stubbed his clearing attempt more than halfway through this third period. Boma to the front, intended for Bolig. Chimera was in good shape. Kuznetsov will drive it wide of the goal looking for the carom. And it's Wiedemann, oop, just dodging Chimera, who went down in a heap. This is Stajan. Veteran pivot back through center.
behind the plate. We got a fight at center ice.
Yes, we do. Bowling wants to go with Chimera. The officials interrupting before they could really square off.
And it's going to be only Bowling going for instigating with Chimera. It should be just a roughing call, and the Caps should have a power play here, Joe.
Bowling has been pretty PO'd all night long. The Missouri native upset this time with Jason Chimera. Caps should be on the power play when you return. Caps have a 3-1 advantage. We had McDonald's trivia for you earlier in the night. Two players in Flames franchise history tied with the most career hat tricks. Immediately you go Theo Fleury.
And then Jerome McGinley.
I'll go Gary Roberts. Kent Nilsson sneaks into your picture. 13 apiece. Too easy to go with Jerome, right?
Yeah, I know.
Forgot about the Magic Man. He's one of the most talented Flames ever. Incredible player.
I have one memory of Kent Nilsson. He was receiving a two-handed slash from Ron Hextall.
One of the first Swedes ever to play in the National Hockey League.
Carlson walks the line.
Two-hander from Hextall.
Yes, did I have it right?
Yes, you do.
It was Kent on a rotation play for Ovechkin. Washington works a man up for another 90 seconds. Carlson steps in. Ovechkin settles through the seam with a bullet pass for Johansson. That was picked by Giordano, and he'll send it away.
And Bowling not only got a two-minute penalty, probably for roughing, but he also got escorted off the ice. He was chit-chatting way too much with the referee. The referee had enough of it, sent him to the locker room.
You just saw the power play stats packaged by the UPS store. Power play goal from Joel Ward back in the opening period. Johansson, great pass. Ovechkin fires, blocked by Englund. And Englund will get it out with the help of Backlund. And then Byron's in solo. Byron to the forehand, stop. Great save, Braden Holtby.
Might be a penalty shot here. They're not going to call a penalty shot, but it was a definite slash at the end of that. Byron shows great speed, breaking through the Capitals' defense. Lucky bounce right here past Carlson. Here's the breakaway, but look at how solid Braden Holtby was. There was absolutely no white net behind him, even when he made the deke. Excellent stop. Nice job by Braden Holtby.
Was Troy Brouwer chopping trees with you in Banff?
Yeah.
It's a pretty good swing. All right, so Washington's got some penalty killing to do with 8:01 to go. Braden Holtby will be laser locked on the puck. Monahan, Raymond, Russell, Weidman out there. Remember, this is going to be a little bit of a four-on-four foray for a while until the minor to Boland expires. Latta and Ward get their signals crossed, so we're four-on-four for about a half a minute. Russell to the high slot, Monahan. His bid blocked by Niskanen. Mason Raymond turns the corner, throws the stiff arm out, and gets pressed to the wall by Green. Dennis Weidman fires, that's blocked by Latta. 4-on-4 for another 15 seconds, and the Caps will be a man down. Joel Ward takes it for a little ride. Niskanen has the puck, and he should be in no hurry either as he checks the overhead scoreboard. Washington is a man down right now for 70 seconds. Beagle hot puts it after Giordano. Brody to the rescue. TJ Brody winds it up through center. Drops it around Orpik. Alsner comes over. Goudreau took his eyes off the puck. Alsner in a sprint. Plays it high on the window and all the way down.
Yeah, Alan May has raved about Alsner all game, and there you see not only the passing but the defensive play, making sure it goes up and off the glass, denying any Calgary thrust against the Caps here on the power play.
Carl Alsner, his wife from this area, mentioned Alsner's outstanding junior career in these parts. Off the boards, Backstrom's behind the D and in alone. Nicholas Backstrom backhand stops.
Yeah.
A save made by Kari Ramo, and then we have more penalties to come.
Yeah, it's going to go against the Caps. The save was made, and then there was a slash at the end of that after the Backstrom stop. And that's why we have a meeting of the minds against the wall. But there will be a penalty for slashing Gold out, I think, against the Caps on this play. Backstrom denied, still pushing and shoving at the sidewall. And it could be Eric Fair that's going off. They're not too pleased with his slash at the end. Glenn Cross gets involved. He'd be better served to step away, Joe, because his team was going to get the extra man on the attack on the power play.
Well, there's no way Glenn Cross can leave here without a penalty. Throwing four punches while the refs have Eric Fair in their grasp, and he throws four punches with his gloves off. That's unacceptable, really, the way the league is trending. You can't let a player do that.
Curtis, Glenn Cross is now pleading his case, Alan, but he's on his way to the dressing room, it appears.
And he should be. And, you know, you look at the undisciplined play by Bolig earlier. You know, the Flames are still on the 3-1. It's their ice. They get the last change. And certainly those aren't the types of penalties that you want to get for your team.
And
at
there's
this
the
point
penalty.
In time.
And that's the penalty right at the end. Watch Fair come in. The initial call was going to be made right there. And then they retaliate. Now we might have coincidental minor penalties. That's undisciplined for the Calgary Flames.
Are you thinking they're calling Fair for the slash he was trying to knock that
definitely,
free?
Definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
Because the puck was underneath Ramos'
exactly.
glove?
Exactly. And that's why all heck broke loose, too. It was that slash on the goalie that has this whole skirmish.
Well, we mentioned these two teams will see each other in 10 days on November 4th at Verizon Center. They'll be in an ornery mood. Right now, Washington has the advantage where it matters most, 3-1.
Yep, one more look at the great save, and then there's the slash that initially was called. The referee's hand went up right away, right in view here on Comcast Sportsnet. And then all of a sudden, it looked like they went berserk and not too smart by Curtis Glenn Cross and the rest of the Flames.
And it looks like, the Flames are shorthanded on this guy. Right now they've got a number seven, Brody is on the board, 2 minutes.
Folks, the Caps' next home game's Wednesday, October 29th. Detroit Red Wings will be in town. You need to visit WashingtonCaps.com or call 800-745-3000 to get yours. Just tuning in with us at the bottom of the hour now, Sunday morning, back home in our nation's capital. The Washington Caps, thanks to a two-goal performance from Joel Ward, have a 3-1 lead. Backstrom with the insurance tally in the first minute of the final frame. 6 minutes and 23 seconds to go in this game. Kari Ramo checking that out on the scoreboard. So for right now, it's another 4-on-4 instance for 23 seconds. Kuznetsov to take this draw. Win it back to Green. Niskanen drive, stopped by Ramo. Rebound is right on top of those pillows, and he'll cover.
That whistle was a little early. That Ramo didn't have that puck. Joel Ward's a little bit upset about it. You could see that puck here the entire time. I think the refs just wanted to get a quick call on that one.
Alan, if you're keeping a scorebook down there, Fair for roughing, Brody for slashing, Glenn Cross for roughing and a misconduct. All of those doled out in that last skirmish.
Well, where was the Brody call? Was that on the Nick Backstrom breakaway right at the start of it?
Had to be. That was what they called slashing.
Yeah, because I was watching Dvorsky the whole time, and I thought it was on the Flames, and then you called it on the Caps, and, you know, I missed the Eric Fair slash, even though it was right in front of me, and very surprising on the way that all shook out.
Worked out perfectly.
Yeah, Curtis Glencross, like I said, that was very undisciplined by him, and, you know, that's one thing the coaches drive him crazy.
Russell towards the front, batted away by Braden Holtby. As Troy Brower will reverse for Niskanen, we drift below 6 minutes in regulation. These power play stats are packaged by the UPS store. Burakovsky turning wide. He's learning all the nuances of the game at center. Green with a chance. Mike Green. Saucer pass to Kuznetsov. Burakovsky, great feed. Ovechkin whiffed on the one-timer, shanked it off the heel of his blade.
What a wonderful pass, cross-seam by Burakovsky. Has he ever had superior hockey sense? He's been effortless here tonight on the road for the Caps.
And I like how Kuznetsov baited the two Flames to come and chase him. He knew exactly what he was doing then with that puck to get it down to Burakovsky. And really Burakovsky all game long. His play without the puck, his toughness on the wall. He really looks like a guy that's more than 18, 19 years old. It looks like veteran, a lot of veteran plays out there, very comfortable inside the defensive zone. And geez, just his work ethic is really second to none right now.
Barry Trotz says he's been A-OK even when things get chaotic on the ice. Backstrom finds Ovechkin, he rings it off the pipe. The big rebound starts Juris all alone down the flank. Closing in on the delay, look at Ovechkin get back and defend. Centering pass, came right on through as Hudler was looking for a redirect. A two-goal lead for Washington, 4:25 to go in the third period.
What happened to all the D there? Ovi was the only one back.
We're 5-on-5 again, for a little while at least. Orpik on through for Chimera. Spins away from Goudreau, but not Raymond. The cheers of go, Flames go. Goudreau tees it up. They send in Raymond on the hop. He looked to slice between defenders. Holtby has the puck, and he'll cover. Back for this one's conclusion, the final 3:57 from Calgary, right after these words. Thompson Creek, window of opportunity. Alex Ovechkin at both ends.
Yeah, first of all, this recent grip off the post, and watch Alex backtrack. And actually has the wherewithal to turn around and play defense. Now skating backwards, great poke check. He did it at one end offensively, just couldn't get it into the net. And at the other end, a splendid defensive play by number 8.
Capitals have taken 3 of the last 4 straight up against the Calgary Flames. They've got a 2-goal lead to protect with a little less than 4 minutes to go tonight. Backstrom beat Monahan on the draw. In the city of Calgary, 42 times the Caps have squared off with the Flames. They've only won 9 of them. Niskanen plays it on through. Fair chops it back. And Giordano will swing. 31-year-old Flame captain, turned 31 this month, coughed it up. Ovechkin roaring in, fires, it's blocked. Alex broke his stick in the process. Backstrom happily spins it back behind the net, guarded by Kari Rommel. We'll keep our eyes on him, see how early Bob Hartley will lift him for the extra skater with his team trailing by 2. Colborne receiving high praise from the coach earlier today in our meeting. Burakovsky sends it on back there for Carlson. Crossed him up with that pass. On the hop comes Byron. Throttled pretty good by Brouwer. It's offside Calgary on the entry. Folks, our Caps player of the game tonight, sponsored by the Palm Restaurant, will choose Joel Ward.
Great game. 7th career multi-goal game for Joel. 4 shots, 2 block shots. He deserves a Palm player of the game. Really helped the Caps offense as he moves down a line and performs well for Barry Trotz.
Can enter to be the Palm fan of the month at thepalm.com/fan. I remember a Joel Ward hat trick in Philadelphia at Wachovia Center. Weidman blasts this one in as the netminder Ramo makes a beeline for the bench.
Hey guys, one thing I want to mention is, you know, dealing with the press here the last few days, Edmonton and Calgary, and, you know, there's so many pointed questions at Ovechkin and on his buy-in with this team and, you know, everything that, you know, he's criticized for around the league. And I'd have to say tonight he's been the best defensive winger for the Capitals. He's been excellent on the back check. He's created some excellent takeaway situations inside the neutral zone. And tough on the boards, not overplaying his position. Teams are overplaying him to take a shot away. But he's done an excellent job without the puck tonight.
Don't worry, Alan, he's uncoachable.
I keep reading that.
Yeah, he's uncoachable. A barb thrown at him recently, north of the border on an intermission telecast. Colborne zigs and zags through center. Pass for Backlund. Joel Ward able to clear. Russell for Weidman on the dump down. The net is empty. Ramo on the bench. Ooh, Braden Holtby thought about it.
Yeah, he did.
He thought about it. As Beagle will clear, he was behind that center line. So this is icing against Washington. Locker earlier tonight, your voice on value, presented by Morgan Franklin Consulting.
And it was all about miscues and minimizing them. Well, I think they've done that here tonight against Calgary. They put together a real good team effort. This is a hard team to play against. The Caps put their hard hats on. You have Orpik throwing 9 hits. You have Carlson and Ulser throwing the puck up in transition. You got Ovi, as Alan May was talking about, being maybe the best I've seen him play both sides of the puck, offensively, defensively. When he's not scoring, sometimes scorers get frustrated. Hasn't been the case for the captain here tonight.
Washington's played a very clean game, only coughed the puck up 5 times tonight. As the timeout has been taken with 2:09 to go, Todd Reirden brings the guys into the classroom. Todd Reirden, who began his NHL career with the Edmonton Oilers. We were there recently on Wednesday night, Edmonton getting the better of Washington. 6 attackers on in red. Reminder, the Caps have the Canucks tomorrow, 9:30 on Comcast Sportsnet. Brooks Orpik almost into double figures in hits tonight. Gets to clean house in front of the Capital goal now. Still plenty of time left, 2:09, and the net empty. They jam for it along the boards. It'll get away from Weidman, covered up by the swift skating Chris Russell. Beagle towards the cage and wide of the goal. He'll check out for a line change. Russell weaves back through center. Finds Colborne. Tended to by Backstrom. There's Orpik jamming it along the dasher. The puck to the point for Russell. Then Weidman, who has the lone goal for Calgary, fires this one. It was off of Eric Fair. 6 attackers on in red. Back to point position. Brower gets there. Pokes it on through. Brower's on his way. Empty net. He fired it wide. Hudler at center. Hudler steps into the attack zone. Cross rink for Raymond. Mason Raymond turns. The late guy is Brody. Hudler to the goal mouth. Answered by Niskanen. And that's out of play.
It's been that type of night for Troy Brower. He's seen a little frustration out of the Capitals' number 20, and they're even more frustration. Sometimes it just snowballs. Unlucky here. The puck's ready for him just to blast it. He wanted to put her home. You could just see him look up to the roof there. Unlucky night for number 20, Troy.
Caps' second leading goal scorer a season ago. We'll get another timeout here. 67 seconds left in regulation time. Joel Ward with 2. Backstrom early in the third. Weidman on the power play for Calgary. You're all caught up on the scoreboard. Hashtag Capitals talk throughout the night. We're asking you which of the Caps you'd like to hang out with for a day in D.C. More answers are coming in.
We have Alan May at one of them, our answer to the question. After that segment turned, gotta say, spend a day with Locker. See, people thought it was good, Joe B.
Which part? The telestration or Banff?
Both.
I like Banff.
Shimmer, without a doubt.
Jason's not crazy. Liam O'Brien wagging the tongue at John Scott. Joel Ward hoping in 67 seconds to be celebrating a victory. Washington potentially improves to 4-1-2 should they hang on. Giordano cruising in from the point position towards the cage, deflected wide. 1 minute to go in this contest. Hudler delicately to the front. Raymond covering up for Brody. Hudler off the head fake. Raymond. Chimera slides. They feed to the high slot looking for Brody, and Backstrom knew it was coming. 40 seconds left in the contest right now. Giordano and the Flames, 2 goals down. Raymond failed to dump it in, and he got throttled by Orpik.
And that was number 10.
Yep, double digits for double digit 4.
A perfect 10. Giordano on the send-in, 23 seconds to go. Colborne waits. Below the goal line for Hudler, flushed out by Fair. Didn't get it out. Thrown back into the corner, 10 ticks left. Carlson zips it around the boards and all the way back with enough starch for an icing against Washington.
What a huge game all around for this Capitals team. They really needed this win, and to a man, they dug deep. And obviously Ward the hero when it comes to scoring, but Orpik, what a game. Look at that finish. Doesn't get any better than that on Mason Raymond. Open ice hits are so difficult. Number 44 has been crazy when it comes to hits tonight.
Never takes very many penalties. You realize no. only once in his career has he ever been over 100 PIMs in a season. Flames control the draw. Wyman with a last-ditch effort. Swatted away by Carlson. And the Washington Capitals prevail on enemy ice. 3-1 in Calgary.
And the boys in white over the boards to come and congratulate Braden Holtby. A fine performance. The guys kept the puck away from the net. Calgary Flames aren't going to burn you on rushes. They're going to burn you on cycles. They defused that. When they did break down, Braden Holtby, a couple of dandy saves. The Capitals, a big win tonight, 3-1 over the Flames.